Bill Nye. My name is Lana, and I have a question about time travel. So recently, I have been searching up various information about a so-called time traveler named John Titer, who claimed that he came from the year 2036 and wrote about all of this in the early 2000s. So I have a question. Can this possibly happen, and can time travel actually exist? So thank you.
Lana, I would say if I understand this guy's claims, they are false. Time travel so far is not possible. There is a very reasonable theory that you could build a time machine in which you go faster or close to the speed of light. Of course, that would kill you because you'd be accelerated in these very small radii and at very high speeds and you'd fly apart. But that aside, you can only go back in time to when the machine was built. It's just a complication. The other thing is, when people make these extraordinary claims, there's generally a way to prove them false, to prove them wrong. And this guy took the trouble to only go to 2036, see if he can tell you who won the Super Bowl. And the other big thing, I always ask those guys, why isn't he rich? Couldn't he have invested in certain stocks? Couldn't he have seen certain eventualities? Outcomes with the stock market, with certain manufacturers, be it the Tesla Automobile Corporation, for example, or the Department of Defense in the United States coming up with some fabulous new invention. Wouldn't he have invested in certain farmland in the right part of the world to be especially productive? And so, you know, why? So on and so on. So I really encourage you to look into this guy's claims. Now, in what we call skepticism or skeptical thought. And you also, it's a very popular phrase right now, critical thinking skill. We evaluate claims. We look to see if a claim is true or false. You look at a specific thing this guy says that happens in the future and see if it really happens. In general, when people make those claims, I'm 60 years old. 60 years old now, Lana. I've been through a lot of claims of the end of the world, a lot of people who said they're from the future, and it's really easy to meet people who say they're from the past, that they were in some extraordinary war in ancient Greece, or that they were, I know a woman who believed or seemed to believe that she was killed in a car wreck in the 1920s, and she used to be this beautiful woman who dressed in flapper clothes, if you know these that era, very distinctive style of dress. And she really believes that till you start asking her questions about who was president, how much money did she have in the bank, what was the price of a gallon of gas, and so on. They don't really know. These things are easily researched. And so I think if you look into this guy's claims, each claim, you'll be able to debunk them. And this is really empowering, Lana. It'll make you feel good, I hope, because you will use your own brain, your own experience, your own outlook on life to determine whether or not someone is essentially lying to you. And this guy sounds like he's lying to you on purpose, but often it's very common I've met these people that are lying to themselves as well. They've gotten their own self caught up in this delusion. But this guy sounds like, I don't know if you know the word charlatan, a trickster, someone who's trying to dupe you, take advantage of you. So look into it and be empowered. Let's change the world.